We created all of them with gene splicing, and we just took the most extreme features in one phase and combined it with features of another phase. And if you pay attention, you can see all of them are still morphing. And we also gave them some new attachments, so random attachments we found in the build. That's why they look a bit funny. But as you can see, all the skin attachments work without clipping, no matter if rigid or elastic. So now, if we take all these heads and put them next to each other and compare them with a T0 with an artist-created model, then I think it's not really obvious that all these 8 heads around Bishop are created by a user with a customizer. So I know it's a bit hard to compare the animation of 8 heads while they are playing at the same time, but this will be on YouTube in a couple of hours or a couple of days, I don't know. But then you can pause the video and compare every single frame if you want, every single pose, and you will see every micro-expression, every emotion is absolutely identical on all these heads. And that's very obvious when you focus on the mouth. The shape of the mouth and the lips are different on every head, but the retargeting works so well that we don't get any weird deformations or clipping. And it's the same for the eyes. They all look different, but they animate in the same way and always close correctly, and they show the same emotions and micro-expressions in every single frame. So Bishop is, of course, a T0 model, and that's why he has a higher resolution mesh and sharper normal maps.